Hey, and welcome to Grace Lutheran Church's worship. Thanks for joining us today. If you ask me who my favorite Bible character is in the Bible, I'm hands down gonna say Moses. I freaking love Moses. Moses is my favorite. Moses is my favorite. And Moses is my favorite for a few reasons. When Moses is called to be a disciple of God, Moses is like, nope, you have the wrong guy. Not me. Nope, not me. And then when he does do what God asks him to do, he has to have a friend come and help him to do it, right? He has to have that support to help him to do it. And then when he's given super important things like the Ten Commandments from God, he breaks them. He just shatters them on the ground. He gets so mad at God's people. He's like, nope, I'm done. And he gets mad. And for those three reasons, plus others, but those three reasons, Moses is my favorite Bible character in the Bible. Moses, to me, is super relatable. I don't know about you, but when I'm called to do something, especially with things I don't want to do, or things that I don't feel like I'm capable to do, I'm like, nope, you have the wrong person, choose someone else, not me, try again. And then usually I'll end up doing it, right? If you end up doing it, sometimes you still don't feel able to do it. You don't feel like you have the tools, so you need someone to help you, walk alongside you to do it. And then sometimes I just get so mad, I'm just like, nope, I'm done. I'm gonna walk away because you guys make me so crazy. Like, what the heck is going on? Like, I don't know what I'm doing, right? You can get so overwhelmed. You're just like, nope. And Moses shows us that even God's disciples, right? Even people who God call can be these kinds of people. And so that's why I love Moses so much. And our story today, our reading, we read from Exodus, not specifically about who Moses is, but we get to read about the Ten Commandments that God gives his people and he gives Moses to bring down to the people. And when we read about the Ten Commandments, we read, right, love your God, have no other gods before me, love your God, don't use my name in vain, honor your mother and father, don't steal, commit murder, all that kind of, you know, please don't do these things. Ten Commandment rules. And we could teach you on the Ten Commandments, but I'm going to go a little bit different. And I'm going to talk about why we follow the Ten Commandments, right? Why do we have no other gods other than God? First of all, it's just God, right? But why do we honor our mother and father? Why do we not steal? Why do we, right, not say God's name in vain? Why is following the Ten Commandments important? And we don't do it well, right? Guarantee you, none of us follow the Ten Commandments well. Before breakfast, you probably broke at least one, if not more, of the Ten Commandments. And it's really, really hard, right? And we're probably never going to do it right because we're imperfect as people. But God still calls us to follow these Ten Commandments. And so we follow these Ten Commandments not because they're rules, right? And not just because God tells us to. But we follow these Ten Commandments because it's our way to show God that we love him. These Ten Commandments give us a deeper relationship with God, right? Sorry, they're barking at a neighbor's dog. The Ten Commandments give us a deeper relationship with God. When we follow the Ten Commandments and we do our best to follow the Ten Commandments, we get closer to God. We get more connected because our heart and our minds and our souls and everything and our actions are all directed towards God. So I watched Alice in Wonderland, the Johnny Depp version made in like 2010 or something, I don't know. But I watched that today to get ready for my children's sermon. And I really like this movie because Alice does not follow all the rules, right? She doesn't follow them at all. And it's not about breaking the rules for Alice, right? But for Alice, it's about living into who she is, right? She is different. And Alice does think six impossible things before breakfast because her dad did. And that's how she grew up and was taught and became her own person. And that's who she is. And so these Ten Commandments, right, they aren't meant to confine us into rules and into blocks and into spaces, right? They aren't meant to confine us in following the rules, but the Ten Commandments are meant to help us find who we are as children of God. What does honoring your mother and father do for you to deepen your relationship with God, to help you? How does honoring your mother and father define you as a child of God, right? Does it help you show God's love to your mom and dad, or does it help you show God's grace to your mom and dad? Or maybe it helps a friend see that, you know, there are good relationships out there. There's lots of cool things that, you know, following these Ten Commandments isn't about the rules, but it's about helping us define who we are as a child of God. So I task you today, to whether you're at home or you're gonna go home later, I task you, put a name tag on yourself, whether you make it out of an actual name tag or you make it out of paper and you tape it to your shirt, I don't care. Make a name tag for yourself. And on the first name tag, I want you to write child of God, right? Because that's what you are named and you are claimed. You are named and claimed as a child of God. And then from these Ten Commandments, I want you to think about ways that these Ten Commandments help define you as a child of God. What do they do to help mold you into a child of God, or to help others see God in you, right? And I want you to, let's just do like two or three, right? Go through the Ten Commandments with your family and talk about how one that commandment, right, that God gave us helps define us as a child of God and really solidifies who we are in God and how we are then sharing God's love. And I want you to put that on another name tag. So we have child of God, right? And then honoring your mother and father. And to me, right, that shows that I also honor God. And so that would be my next name tag, child of God, honoring God. And then, right, maybe, I would do not saying God's name in vain, right? Not saying God out loud or accidentally using it in non-church context, talking to God. And so if I follow that rule defines me because now it shows that I respect God. So I'm a child of God who honors and who respects God. And so you'll have kind of this line of name tags, or you can do it whatever way you want, right? You'll have this line of name tags that really shows you that not only are you a child of God, but these rules aren't about confining you, but they're about helping you solidify and finding who you are as a child of God. So go in peace and go name and claim the Lord, because you are a child of God.